All right, y'all, we're back. Video two of the day. We just went over how to do the momentum crossover. Now we finna go over how to do the momentum spam. So as you've seen with the clips on screen, bruh, I just finished my streamed 2.5 hours, recorded one video, recorded two videos. I'm on the second one now. I'm finna drop this and go to the next. But y'all already seen I'm breaking the game. I know you see right here this little half spin behind the back. We got our double crosses. We got all that stuff. And I already went over how to do the momentum crossover. So hopefully y'all have already seen that video. Today's video, we're gonna go over how to do the momentum spam. But as you can see, look at it. The game is still installing and I've already figured out a good amount of their dribbling system. You see me doing a 360 behind the back. I'll go over that later. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, I've pretty much already broken this game down. The movement system is like, it's like 2K17 movement system with 2K20 dribbling. The way I would describe it, I would say it's 2K20 dribbling with a pinch of 2K17 on it. You know what I'm saying? That's pretty much what it is. But if you haven't checked out my last video, I went over how to do the momentum cross, and we're gonna go over that right now briefly. If you want a more in-depth explanation, go to that video. But to do the momentum spam, you have to be able to do the momentum cross. So as shown on screen, to do the momentum cross this here, you don't hold sprint. So in other years, sometimes you click sprint first, sometimes you click the stick first. This year, no sprint at all, no turbo. It's all stick movement. So we flick the right stick to the right and then the left stick to the right when the ball's in the left hand and we're standing still. Pretty basic, no turbo involved, just a simple two-stick flick of 1-2 movement, of boom, 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 like right stick, left stick, in that direction. Now, when we're crossing to the left and the ball's in the right hand, we're flicking the right stick to the left and then the left stick to the left. Once again, it's a simple 1-2 motion, boom, boom, 1-2. That's how you do momentum cross that way. So essentially, you flick both sticks away from the ball hand. And yep, that's pretty much how it works. Right stick before left stick, that's all you gotta know. It's a 1-2 timing, you know, movement, whatever that may be. Whatever dialect you wanna use for it. But anyways, bro, now let's go over the spam, all right? Now what we're all here for, to do this spam you see on screen right here. To do the momentum spam, obviously we need 86 ball control, but we're in the prelude, so we got it. So to do the spam, starting with the right hand for this case, you're gonna flick your right stick to the left and then left stick to the left. And then you see on the second controller, you then do both back to the right. So you're pretty much ping-ponging the ball back and forth. And you wanna do it as soon as the ball hits the top point on your player's hand. So when you see me cross over to the left, as soon as the ball gets to the highest point on my left arm, that's when I go back to the right. So you know how to momentum cross to the left, and you know how to momentum cross to the right. But now what you gotta focus on is timing it, because you can't do it too quick, but you can't do it too slow. So you have to hit the cross back to the other side when the ball has fully gotten to the left hand. And then once it's at that top point, that's when you cross back. So essentially, if I cross to the right, a momentum cross, when the ball gets to the top point, when my player lifts the ball as high as he does on the right hand, that's when you flick it back to the left. And of course, it's the same thing going back to the right. You cross to the left, you let it get to that top point on the crossover to the left when you lift the ball up with your left arm, and then you momentum back to the right, and that's how we spam. Now, if you're wondering the requirements, obviously, I'm using Paul George. You see you load in with Kawhi Leonard right here. This is footage from my last video, but I explained pretty much that you want to hit select and switch it to passing. Dribbling is good for certain moves, but I'm not gonna lie, in the dribbling setting, you have Pat Beverly and he can't even do a momentum crossover. Yeah, nice 2K. Anyways, bro. So yeah, go to passing and take PG, and this is gonna be the easiest thing. And for anyone that's asking, momentum behind the back. Look at this behind the back right here, guys. That's what we have for an explosive behind the back. Absolutely terrible. You thought 2K couldn't even balance the game out with the explosive behind the back last year. They completely gave up on it this year. It just looks terrible. terrible. So anyways, bro, to learn dribble moves, I highly recommend for beginners, go on to passing and use Paul George. And then for advanced dribblers, use Patrick Beverley, because for someone that can't speed boost, he has the best sigs. I'm not going to lie. I've already seen people doing delayed spin backs, 18 and a half spins, moonwalks, all that, bro. So anyways, make sure you use Paul George in the passing mode in the 2KU because he has 86 ball control. For those watching this video when the year is out and you're learning it on your build, you need 86 ball control to speed boost. That allows you to do the momentum crossover, in turn allowing you to be able to do the momentum spin. All right, so that pretty much sums it up. Now, if you're wondering, future tutorials coming out for anyone that enjoyed this video and that thought this was helpful. I just made a momentum crossover tutorial, then I made this tutorial, doing this all in one day. I'm about to go record a moonwalk tutorial and the new 360 behind the back move that y'all saw in the intro. So anyways, if anyone's looking to learn some new moves, some crazy moves, make sure you stay tuned. If you're watching this video when it first drops, make sure you stay tuned. Another video is finna pop out any second. And if you're watching this later in the year, feel free to check out the other videos that I dropped after this, because by the time you're watching it, I've probably already done the 360 behind the back in the moonwalk tutorials. And I'm also, after I get all my tutorials out, build video, news video, all that, man. So make sure you stay tuned. Right now as we speak, I'm working on trying to figure out, you see me dribbling in circles here, I'm trying to figure out how to do a backwards behind the back into a backwards 360 behind the back dribble, which is the tutorial I'm gonna make later today. But anyways, bro, y'all seen all the moves I'm trying to break here. You gotta stay tuned, bro. I'm finna break down everything, y'all. We're really gonna figure this game out. Y'all can learn from me as I learn from just busting my fingers in the sticks all afternoon. So anyways, bro, that's all you gotta know. Momentum spam, momentum cross. Make sure you're using Paul George. Hopefully y'all enjoyed the video. I will be back, as I said before. So make sure you have the noties on. I'm finna go over all the moves in this game. It's been Matt. Thank y'all so much for the support. Hopefully y'all enjoyed the videos. I will be streaming the play now mode later. And yeah, not much else to say. Make sure you follow up my Twitter, all that. Make sure you got all my socials linked, because I'm finna go crazy. When this prelude is done, you're gonna see a ton of tutorials, and I'm out. Peace.